Marabu's graphics line includes aqua inks, aqua pens, and fineliners. They're all water-based, highly pigmented, and light-fast. Best of all three product lines are included in our brand new Marabu Mega Promotion that begins today, and they're all discounted by 50%. In today's video, I'll show you a little about each, and we'll demo them on our newest freebie, Watercolor Art Part Halloween Pumpkins. Let's talk about the basics first. All three products, the aqua pens, aqua inks, and the fine liners, are all water-based and light-fast. The aqua pens and inks are both re-wettable, so you can go back and rework an area if you want. These are the aqua inks. They're sold in these 15 mL bottles. There are 14 colors in the line. These are the aqua pens. There are actually 24 colors in the line, though I don't have them all here. And they are not sold as open stock right now. There are 5 different sets, including one that, if you want, you can grab all 24 colors at once. So let me slide some things out of the way here, and I'm going to bring in our current freebie, and this, I'll talk about this a little bit more. So when you talk about the aqua inks, because they're pigment-based, I'm going to give this a good shake. They produce really bright, vivid colors. The color is really dense, and you'll see that when I put this on. So this is what you get. I'm just going to grab, I've got a big old brush here. I've got some plain water off to the side. So I've just dampened my brush and I'm going to just dry it off. And I'm going to grab a bunch of the color. And you can see how dense that color is. I mean, there is a lot of pigment in here. So you've got this really bright, vivid color thing going on. I'm going to rinse most of that orange out. And then I can come in here and I can start blending this out if I want. And I can do all kinds of those fun watercolor things. All very easy to do with the aqua inks. Let me grab another pumpkin and I will show you the aqua pens. All right, so let's just pick. This is a color. We'll just grab this. This is another of the freebies. Again, we'll talk about that a little bit more. So here's the contour tip. You can do all of the normal fun things with this. And then on the other side is a brush tip. So for those of you who like to brush letter, who like to do various things, taking advantage of the shape of that brush on the end, that fiber brush on the end, you absolutely can do that. So there are 24 colors in the fine liners, and they differ, and I don't have, well, I have the black here. So this is one of the sets. This is 4 of the black in the fine liner set. There are 24 colors in all, and they're quite different from the aqua inks and pens in that they're not re-wettable. In fact, they're permanent once they're dry, and that's where it gets interesting. So using these pumpkins as an example, I'm going to come back. In fact, let me see if I can grab one here that's done. So this is a pumpkin that I did, and all of the black work that you see on here was done with the fine liners, which means that this is not re-wettable. The colors are going to stay, so when I come back, I can put all my elements, my facial elements in there with one of the fine liners, and when I come back with the aqua ink, I can layer on all of this color and it's not going to change. Those pens, all those marks are going to stay put. So let me clean this up, I'll come back and I'll show you how marvelously all of this stuff works together on the watercolor paper that is the art parts and of course our journals. These pumpkins are our current freebie. If you spend $25 in products, excluding gift certificates, we'll give you a set that includes 5 each of the 3 shapes. So there's 1, 2, 3, we'll give you 15 pumpkins. You don't have to do anything. The warehouse will automatically include them. All right, so let's bring these out, get these out of the way for 1 second. There are 24 colors in the fine liner set. This, how awesome is that artwork? Is that not just the most amazing thing? This is the set that includes all 24 colors. There also is a set that includes 4 black pens. Now the thing to bear in mind with these pens, all of these, the tip is 0.5 mm. Here you have a 0.2, a 0.4, and a 0.8 mm, and a brush pen. The thing to remember is though this brush pen looks the same as the brush pen from the aqua inks, excuse me, the aqua pen line. Different. This is fine liner ink and it's going to stay put when it's dry so that you don't have to worry about coming back and changing it. So while the aqua pens are re-wettable, the aqua inks are not. They are going to stay put. When I do the sketching, and I'm going to bring in another one of these pumpkins, when I do this, I've got pencil lines on here that you might not be able to see. I'm going to use the 2 millimeter tip, excuse me, the 0.2 millimeter tip, because I like the really thin lines that it gives me, and I can get really nice and sketchy if I want. If you can't think of what a really fun or interesting jack-o'-lantern face looks like, Google it. You will find a bajillion results, something that you can work from. So I'm just going to come in and quickly sketch these marks, and I'm not worried about covering my pencil marks exactly. If I want to come back, it's hard to talk and do this. If I want to come back and erase, I certainly can. You can see how nice and fine this line is. 0.2 millimeter is pretty darn small. Okay, so there's my face. I'm going to grab a couple of the yellows, orange and vermilion. Those are the colors, whoops, that's green. Those are the colors that I found have worked the best. Again, this is a pigment-based product, so I'm going to shake it first. And I'm going to grab an appropriately sized brush. I've got, as I mentioned, the water off to the side. You saw how deep the colors are when it comes straight from the bottle. I tend, although I might need to dip into the bottle here because these features are fairly large, I tend to mostly, this is not what I want. Where's the orange? Here's the orange. Okay, sorry. Now that I have the orange, I tend to dip into, you know what, I didn't shake this. I tend to dip into the cover more often than not. Sorry, that was a really unwieldy pause while I figured out which one was orange. Anyway, I tend to work from the covers because you just don't need all that much. So you can do this one of two ways. I'm going to put a little bit of water on my brush, and then I'm going to pick up some of the lemon. When you look at a jack-o'-lantern that is illuminated with something, whether it's a little LED or it's a candle inside, you're always going to see all of this come up as yellow. So I'm going to start with the lemon. I'm going to deepen the color a little bit with this one is sunshine yellow. And then I'm going to grab just the tiniest bit of orange and kind of deepen the edge there a little bit. I'm not doing a great job here because it's hard to do this and talk, but you can do a better job, I'm sure. If I need to come back and add some more of this, I can. Remember, these are re-wettable, so I can change this whenever I want. I'm not going to do all of the features because we'll be here forever, but I will come back and I will do the nose just so you can see how that's done. Grab a little bit more of the sunshine, and then I can grab just a touch of the orange. Well, that was more than a touch, but nevertheless, it all works. So before I can think about washing color on the background, and ordinarily I would let this dry, but I'm going to need to dry this because otherwise I'll be working wet into wet, and the color is going to end up where I don't want it. And by the color, I mean the orange color that is going to be the pumpkin. So I'm going to shake up vermilion because I'm going to use a little bit of that too. Some of this. Now I'm going to go back to a little bit larger brush because I'm working on a fairly good sized area. So for this, I like to actually wet the background of the pumpkin with some water before I do anything else because it's going to allow me, where is my paper towel? It's going to allow me to control where the orange is going to go. The ink will, like, these are watercolors. The ink is going to, the color is going to follow the water. So by having the facial features dry and laying water down on the background, that's going to help me keep the orange color away from the facial features. And we're going to ignore the fact that the mouth and the eyebrows aren't done. It is what it is. All right, so again, this is not great art. I just want to show you how this works. I'm going to pick up some orange from the cover, and I'm going to hold this with my finger, and I'm just going to start brushing color, and you can see that it bleeds. It's following the water, which is pretty much what you want. Again, I'm not doing a super good job here, but you can see in the examples, if you take your time you're going to get really nice results. I'm keeping the darker color along the outside edge, and I'm going to reinforce that by coming back with the vermilion and darkening the outside edges. So I'm waiting to do this inside till I know that a lot of the color is gone from my brush, and that's going to give me a natural highlight. I'm not going to have to work for it. It's just going to happen. Oops, well, it's way too much color. It's just going to happen. Again, wrong color. It's just going to happen because there is less of the color in. Okay, I see a spot that's not wet. For this to work, it's all going to be uniformly wet, or the process does not work correctly. All right, coming back to the orange. Go ahead and stroke that color in here. If I need a little bit more, I can grab it. All right, if I think that color's gotten a little bit too dark, all I need to do is bring some more water in to lighten it. And this had started to dry, and you see that it's so easy to re-wet, it's just a matter of bringing in some of the color. Okay, so there is the initial color. Now I'm going to bring in, whoops, some of the vermilion, which is what is in this cap. I might thin that with just a little bit of water, and I'm going to come in and I'm going to stroke it on here. And I'm going to grab some water because it needs a little bit. Okay. Let's do the same thing. It's more of the vermilion, thin it with a little bit of water. Now I'm going to come back with a slightly wetter brush here because I know that this has already started to dry because this is the first side that I did. A little bit of water just to thin that out so I can get some smooth gradations here in the color changes. Again, I am not doing a really good job. This is one of those do as I say, not as I do kind of things. I need a little bit more water. Again, I just want to kind of smooth this out. And it is this simple. I mean, it has not taken me long to do this. Certainly, I did not do a fantastic job, but if we come back and we look at the samples that I did where I spent a little bit more time, you can see that it's really easy to get this look. Now, I did use a little bit of stickles in the nostrils, and I came back. So here's the thing. Once this is all dry, you can come back and you can add some more details. So the cross-hatching on the eyes and the corners of the mouth, I did that once all the color was in place. The ribs on the pumpkin, again, I came back with that 0.2 millimeter and did the same thing and put those in place. Now, the other thing to think about with the fine liners is that you can doodle to your heart's content with a 0.5 millimeter tip. These are fine enough to get some really nice thin lines. So if you're a tangler or you enjoy doodling, the fine liners are going to be a perfect choice for that. And with 24 colors, it really opens all of your possibilities. So this is the barest beginning of the ways that you can work with the Marabu Graphix products. Saving 50% on all of them means you can splurge and buy them all if you want.